Welcome to my channel. Today I've got a face paint look for you this time. I really felt like doing something with flowers, something bright and funny and just, I don't know, colorful, springtime, summer, that sort of thing. Also, I tried out a new way, or at least a new way to me, for painting flowers. So I think these actually are probably the best flowers I've ever painted. Which, you know, like I am absolutely awful at painting flowers, so I'm quite pleased right now. But yeah, I'm going to show you how to do this in a moment, obviously, because it's a tutorial. Yep. But before that, I just wanted to mention, if you want to see more makeup tutorials, I also do a lot of more wearable looks and specifically eye looks. Yeah, you can always subscribe to my channel if you want to see those. And I also do chatting videos, nail art videos, piercing videos, whatever else I can think of. So yeah. Other than that, if you want to see pictures of makeup and pictures of other things I happen to encounter in my daily life and want to share on Instagram, you can always follow me on Instagram as well. I'll put my name down below here. And without further ado, let's get started. I'm going for a BB cream today just because I want to go for something quite fresh face. So I'm just using BB cream and concealer as for now. Which I think will give me enough coverage for this kind of look. I'm not going for a full coverage thing because I'm going to be painting stuff on my face anyway. So it's not as if it's going to stay even. Now, because this is a BB cream and not a foundation, I am going to put a little bit of a concealer, the same shade as my skin, on some spots on my face, because it's that time of the month again. And then with two other concealers, I'm just going to highlight and do my under eye area. You know what to me is one of the most like annoying sounds ever? Me when I'm like humming along with music or just humming a song without there being any other music around, blah. And I do that quite a lot. I always edit it out because I don't want to torture any of you. So I end up only torturing myself because I end up hearing it when I'm editing and it really sounds not very good. Just quickly setting everything. With which my oily skin is not a necessary luxury. Okay, I'm not going to fill in my eyebrows in any way because I want to keep them very natural and they already are, but I do gotta say I do tint my eyebrows and eyelashes, so my eyelashes and eyebrows are already colored and visible. If you have thinner eyebrows by nature, or, you know, have very pale eyebrows and want to fill them in, of course, it's okay too. Just depends on how you want the entire thing to look. For blush, I'm applying, as you can see, quite a lot. I'm not going for a natural look, obviously, so... yeah, it's up to your own preferences with all things really in a makeup look, but I'm going to go quite heavy with the blush. I'm using a shimmery one, so it's sort of like immediately a highlight. I'm also applying this alongside my nose, like some very... a natural contour. I'm just applying the blush to my creases as well. Really just to get the color there, like this isn't going to give any form of depth because it's a very pale, slightly shimmery color, obviously. But this is just going to make sure that the eyes just play along with the rest of the face. I am going to apply very, very big falsies. So, yeah, it doesn't really matter if it's like properly blended because you're not really going to see much else than the vague color anyway. Now, because I'm going to wear falsies, I am going to put some liquid liner in my inner corners. And also along my entire upper lash line, just to make sure that the lash bandage is going to blend in nicely and not give a random vague black line that just somehow ends somewhere without any, you know, seemingly purpose to it. I'm just going to fill in my bottom eyelashes while the eyelash glue is drying on the eyelashes. Yeah. I'm using dark brown for it this time because I do want them to be sort of balanced with the falsies, but I don't want them to be too much. What I'm going to do first now is to map out where I want the flowers to be, just with color. And I'm just meanwhile mixing a little bit of paint. But anyway, I'm using this self-made tiara, like headpiece thingy with flowers, just to have an example of flowers. Most things I paint, I just paint for my mind, but I'm awful at flowers, so it just seemed like a decent idea to actually, yeah, make sure that I paint them correctly this time. I am going to do blue flowers instead of white ones though, simply because I'm very pale. If you have darker skin, you can of course do white flowers, but on me they would sort of just fade to the back. So yeah. And I'm starting out with the pink roses, and like I said, I'm just vaguely mapping out where I want the rose to be. Really, I saw Matthew Luke on YouTube do this, and I figured, hey, that's probably a lot better than what I've been doing, which was basically just desperately trying to make something look like a flower, and then ending up with something that decidedly did not look like a flower at all, one bit, period. So, yeah, I'm just trying to do it the smart way now. It's okay to have them overlap a little bit. Just makes it look more natural. Okay, the blue one was one by Ben Nye, of which I'm actually not sure if it's supposed to be a face paint or an eyeshadow, but as an eyeshadow it didn't really give off any color. So I assumed it was a face paint, but apparently with water it still doesn't really give off much color, so I'm just switching to a different product. Then with black face paint and a lot of water, I'm just dipping the brush in the water, then I'm patting it at the center of the flower. And then I'm wiping off the brush on a towel or face halo or anything you have nearby. Office chair, for example. And then I'm just dabbing out the edges of the black, just to make sure that there's like a little bit of a shadow at the center of the flower. I'm just mixing whatever color the flower is with a little bit of black. Just to make everything just a tiny bit darker. So that I can start doing the outlines of the little petals. Now I'm doing the same thing pretty much only in white. So I'm using very watery white face paint, and I'm just going inside of where I've put the outlines, just to highlight the little edges of the petals. Makes the entire thing look a little bit more 3D. Flowers with centerpieces do get their centers at this point with little dots. Okay, I don't think flowers will ever be my one and only main talent in the world. But I gotta say, this turned out about 385 times better than I anticipated it to. Aim low, then it can only be better than you expected. But yeah, seriously though, I do think these are pretty much maybe the best flowers I ever painted, which doesn't say a lot, I know, but for me this is actually quite an accomplishment. So I'm happy with it, but now I'm just gonna grab some green face paint and just add some very, very simple petals. Really very simple petals, like sort of a one-stroke-ish thing, just because I don't want to drag any attention away from the flowers that I just put all that effort in. Just dragging the brush. And then pushing, and then just, yeah, then you got like a very, very simple leaf. And I'm just going to do a number of those all around the little flowers. I think the key with these is always to not add too many, just because it can very easily become way too busy otherwise. Okay, we're done, I think, and I just realized that I'm going to have to restyle my bangs a little bit, because otherwise I'm going to be covering my bangs yet again. Not covering my bangs. Using my bangs to accidentally cover part of my face paint again. Yeah. But anyway. First I'm going to do my lips though. I'm going to use a pink pencil on those first, and then I'm going to add a lip gloss. Okay, I kept the lip gloss mostly in the middle just to make my lips look bigger, and there we're done. And that leaves us with the final results. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And yeah. Other than that, if you want to know exactly what I put on my face today, I'll put a list down below in the video description as always. And other than that, that's it for today. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day. And I hope to see you next time. Bye!